PHP Unit is a simple tool to test your PHP code. But how you can start from scratch with PHP Unit? So in the browser, let's type PHP Unit, search for the Google, and you will get the website for PHP Unit. That's great. But we are interested in this GitHub repository of Sebastian Bergman. Okay, so let's open this GitHub repository. And you can take a look on this website, which is very descriptive, not so cool, but good to start. Let me show you how you can actually start. So here we have this PHP Unit GitHub repository. And here if you go, you can see we have the installation part. You can install by wget or PHP Unit, like these kind of things. But alternatively, you may use Composer to download. And for that, we need to go to getting started. Yeah, here to download via Composer, that will be easy when you start with Composer. And if you don't know about the Composer, it's just a package tool or dependency manager, which allow you to download packages for PHP related things. I don't need to copy this. We can just write it. But before that, what we can do, we will create a folder, so mkdir, and I will call it PHP Unit Test. Okay, so this is good, and let's go to PHP Unit Test, and here we will say composer, then require PHP Unit slash PHP Unit, and yes, that has to be a dev dependency, because when you are developing, when you are on localhost, then only you need to test. So hit enter. What it will do, it will download PHP Unit package on a new folder which will be created by this command called vendor folder. So let's wait for this to complete. So now you can see PHP Unit is installed. So let's go to this PHP Unit Test folder we have created. And yes, we have three files. So why not open this with VS Code? And now we have three files. So let's look at this composer.json file. It's simple and it's just saying that, okay, require a dev dependency, which is PHP Unit 7.1. And in this vendor folder, yeah, we have lots of things, but the interesting folder in which we are interested is bin folder. And here is the executable PHP Unit. So how we run this? So let's open the integrated terminal of VS Code, and here I will type, let's try to type PHP Unit. It says PHP Unit is not found. If you want to run PHP Unit directly, then you need to install that PHP Unit globally, but it's not required, because in the Laravel, if you are using Laravel, already give you PHP Unit, so it's not a good idea to have PHP Unit globally. But how we can run PHP Unit? So you need to actually go to vendor slash bin slash PHP Unit, and that should be vendor. Okay, so if I hit enter, yes, now you can see we are getting lots and lots of options, but we want to run something. It's not running, it's just giving PHP Unit related commands or its related information. You can see lots of information we have, but we want to create something, like I have some function, I want to check it. For that, we need to create a new file for our PHP Unit, which is called phpunit.xml. And because it's a XML file, we need to start with XML, and let's close this XML also. So this is good, and slash close. Then version, which version of XML we are going to use, which is 1.0. Or after that, we need to say encoding, and encoding is UTF-8. Simple things. Then we will say PHP Unit, and this is going to start the XML part. So here, let's close this PHP Unit. Okay, And in this tag, we need to define from where this PHP unit get starts. So for that, we need to say bootstrap. That means the starting point, not the CSS bootstrap styling. It's the starting point. So bootstrap is actually inside vendor. We have autoload.php file. So this is, if you go to vendor folder, you will get this autoload file, which is just for initializing purpose. Yeah, we have this. And remember one thing, that this has to be like this. That's why it's not highlighting. Okay, so XML is good. And inside this PHP unit tag, we need to define something. There are two tags we need to define. First is test suits. And remember, this has to be with S. And test suits. Inside this, because this is a plural, we need only one singular, test suit, not with S, not test suits. So make sure we have this test suit. And inside this, we need to define the directory where we are going to put our tests. So directory, and let's make it like this, directory. And directory name is tests. We will create this. We don't have yet. And let's name this one as, let's say, unit test. Okay, simple. So let's create a new folder called tests, and let's create another folder inside tests folder, not here, inside tests folder, called unit test. And this part is just going to say to PHP unit that, okay, let's start from tests folder. Whatever you get inside this tests folder have some kind of test. So go look at that. And if you find something, just make that test run. So what if I now go to this terminal, integrated terminal here, and clear it. And let's once more run vendor bin PHP unit. Let's see the result. It says no tests executed, and you can see the difference between last one and this one. But let's define colors, and we are just going to say, okay, show me some colors when you are using this PHP unit. And if I now go, you can see this time this no test is with colors. One thing more is verbose. Verbose is true. And what this mean, if I now say, you can see we have some other related informations with this test and this test, giving some more informations related to test. And one last thing, which is stop on failure. As the name suggests, whenever some test fails, it stop executing other tests, so that you will have a good idea that, okay, our tests is not completed, it breaks, we need to fix it. So our phpunit.xml file is completely done. So this is good, but you know, every time I write vendor/bin/phpunit is, I don't like this actually. So I need some kind of shortcut. And we don't have any kind of test. It says no test executed. So we will create test in this unit folder, and we will see what the package or extension need for VS Code to make these tests flawless without writing these things and these things in the next episode. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get the notification instantly whenever I upload any video. And follow Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, and you can find the next video's link in the description and also the whole playlist. So we will meet in the next episode. Till then, goodbye.